Hey guys, if you're new here, this is Dr. JT, general medicine resident and a part-time YouTuber, and I welcome you to my channel, Dr. JTM. And have you subscribed to my channel? If not, go subscribe it and also click the bell icon so that you won't miss any video. And also in today's video of career guidance, the branch we are talking is the upcoming and the most independent branch, that is none other than anesthesia. And we really have a special guest to talk about it. She will be talking all the pros and cons about this branch anesthesia and how will be the future and what all the life of a PG if they take anesthesia branch. And we also have a special fun round in which we'll be asking some teasing questions, so don't miss any of it. Watch till the end and let's start the career guidance video. Anesthesia.
It is said that anesthesiologist is a physician to a surgeon and a surgeon to a physician. Also jokingly, it is often referred as 99% boredom and 1% terror.
Hello ma'am, welcome to my channel Dr. JTM, and I'm really happy to have you on my channel. Particularly this kind of video, the career guidance, guiding PG aspirants into your branch, anesthesia. And I have a lot of questions to ask you about how this branch will be for PG aspirants if they really want to take, and what about the future if they really enter into this anesthesia branch. And I think you are all set to answer all those questions.
Hi, thank you for inviting me into this. Firstly, I would like to congratulate all the students who have cleared their NEET PG and are waiting for their counselling. Happy to answer all your questions, and I'm ready.
Thank you, ma'am. So, in this interview, we'll be having three segments, ma'am, of which the first segment is about the importance of your branch anesthesia, and second segment will be about how the life of a PG aspirant will be when they enter into this PG branch, and the third segment will be a fun teasing round where we'll be asking some teasing questions to all your anesthetists. And shall we start the first segment, ma'am?
Yes.
So, the first segment is about the importance of your branch. Ma'am, the first question is, I want to know, why only anesthesia? What essence did you really find in anesthesia?
The best thing any doctor can ever do to his patient is to relieve him from his pain and to resuscitate him in terms of emergency, in times of his emergency. In that way, I feel anesthesia has a special role in this perspective.
So the next question will be, ma'am, why did you make this choice? Like, is it your primary choice of taking anesthesia, or you have 2 to 3 options in your list in that you have opted anesthesia, or you just opted anesthesia just because you don't have any chance?
Actually, this is just my personal perspective. I'm not too much into an OP kind of branch. I don't like sitting behind a desk and writing a prescription, something like that. I'm a little more active during my intern days or something like that. I thought seeing OP is not my cup of tea. I had little dilemma between general surgery and anesthesia. General surgery was my first option, actually. Just before my counseling and after my ranks and all, I went to one or two hospitals. I've seen, get into the OR, seen here and there. I decided anesthesia is for me. Okay. I think I thought I'll be comfortable with anesthesia. Okay. I chose anesthesia as my first option.
So the next question I would like to ask, what role do anesthesia really play in the world, entire world, and also in India particularly?
See, the first thing, anesthesia is like a perioperative medicine. We treat any patient, like before the surgery, during the surgery, and after the surgery. And also in times of emergency, outside the OR, for resuscitation, ICU, trauma, acute and chronic pain, procedural sedations again, like in an anxious patient who has to undergo MRI, ERCP, something like that.
So with that aspect, you think anesthesia really in a world like this, in a country like this, does it really have a primary role, or we can say it is next to something, some other branch?
To be frank, I think pandemic has brought us more into the limelight these days. I feel, yeah, anesthesia is one of the leading top branches.
At present.
Yeah. That's also the demand supply ratio is a bit more tilted towards anesthesia, I feel. And COVID-19 has proved it yet again.
Yes, ma'am. That is a convincible point, I would like to say. And ma'am, if that is really true, and what about the people who are thinking that they want to take USMLE or PLAB and go to other countries and practice anesthesia or any branch related to critical care or emergency medicine? What do you suggest? Like, they need to do that going into another country, or they can stay here and do the same?
Yeah, it depends again up to you, but I think other like UK or US have better technologies. Anesthesia is still a developing branch. Okay. Like you see, in the beginning, we were intubating with conventional laryngoscopes. Now we went to video laryngoscopes, slowly fiber optic, and nerve blocks, landmark guided nerve blocks. We went into peripheral nerve stimulator guided blocks. Now it is ultrasound guided blocks. It is still developing. I think other countries will give you a little more edge into going into more technologically better things.
If that point is considered, when will that kind of development will be seen in India with respect to this anesthesia branch?
Very soon, and you see, it all depends on, again, investment the corporate hospitals are putting into this particular branch. With the advent of interventional pain techniques and advanced, introp monitoring techniques and all, we are advancing, maybe very soon.
Okay, so we can say that they can see all that advancements in like 2 to 3 years, and they need not really struggle hard for taking into US, MLE or UK.
Yeah, absolutely, yes.
Okay, then the next question will be, ma'am, tell the importance of your anesthesia branch for a PG aspirant who is in real dilemma to take this anesthesia.
Why anesthesia? Like, see, most of the people have not experienced what anesthesia is like during their internship. So I would like to say, just speak to any, if you know any anesthesia senior, just speak to them. And if you are really into some sort of, you are ready to work hard, you are ready to be on your toes during any emergency, you're not a chill kind of person like that, I think it would be better for you to choose anesthesia.
Okay, that's really a valid point, ma'am. So then, yes, with that point, if a PG aspirant is convinced and he wants to take a good college, what are the top 5 colleges in India, for particularly government colleges, that would be great for anesthesia?
I cannot particularly make very little list of top 5. I would like to say is just know the number of surgeries that happen in a day or in a month in that particular hospital. Also know the number of working hours you are about to work, number of beds in the ICU, what are all the equipment they have related to anesthesia there. Also, the important point is you need to know how many colleagues you have in your branch, because more the colleagues, your work will be a little bit lesser, it will be comfortable.
So, based on the criteria, we need to opt the college, not
obviously,
based on the
yeah. Also, you choose your, if there are any super specialty branches in that college, so general surgery, super specialties, you will get to do more of super specialty anesthesia, and that will give a extra edge.
Yes, that is a really very good point. Not just with the fame of the hospital or fame of the place or the city, you don't need to opt a college. Just do a background check, and with that, ma'am, even it is same with the private colleges, right?
I feel most of the private colleges don't have super specialty general surgery branches. Maybe that gives a little lesser experience, I feel.
Than when compared to
government colleges, yes.
Yes, so with that, we have completed the first segment where we have known the importance of anesthesia branch. But we have a lot to know about how the life of a PG student will be when he is into or she is into anesthesia. So let's enter into the second segment, the life of a PG student in anesthesia branch. And the first question would be, tell us the workload of an anesthetist or anesthesia PG, comparing the government college and also a private college.
First year residency is really going to be very tough. It's better to be prepared. Most importantly, it is because you have never been to anesthesia posting. You need to get adjusted to the work. You need to get adjusted to your new environment, new superiors. Apart from that, you need to do so many things like pre-anesthesia checkup, attending ICU rounds, doing post-operative ward rounds, etc. I think it's going to be a little hectic, and emergency duties are going to be really hectic no matter where it is, government or private.
Okay.
Because you get code blue calls, emergency calls, resuscitation, intubation calls, everything. I think your night duties will be a little more hectic than you expect.
They should be prepared well to work like 24/7 if they are on duty.
Yes.
So ma'am, I would like to know what should be the approach of an anesthesia PG, like in the terms of learning the skill or learning the theory part?
First thing is, don't rush into anything. First keep observing what your seniors are doing, how they are doing, step by step. There will always be steps for any procedure. What's the first step, second step, third step, and then slowly go into plan A, plan B. If this fails, what you're going to do, what your seniors are doing, and these things. Always remember, call for help. If you cannot do anything, always call your senior, because when it comes to anesthesia, either you are saving a patient or you're not going to save a patient. It's not like in between that. So you always have to be very careful. Don't rush into learning something. Don't rush into reading from the beginning. Just observe, slowly learn skills. talk to your seniors, ask their help. Slowly, by the end of 1 month or 2 months, you will know what to read, what is necessary. Slowly go in. Don't rush anything.
Yes, ma'am. Because even the freshers now, the new batch who are getting into the anesthesia, like what message exactly you want to give? Like they need to immediately go and buy the textbooks and take up that subject into them? Or then, as you said, the observationship is more important, which is the primary aspect as a fresher.
I would like to say not to buy any books immediately because the 2020 guidelines have changed completely. Like 2020 CPR guidelines have changed, 2020 sepsis guidelines have changed. Like every 5 years there will be a change. I think the books need to get updated.
Okay.
Just keep learning, keep observing. Slowly when the new editions come, read the PDFs, see the book which suits you, see the language which suits you. See, anesthesia, there are separate UK regulations and US regulations. Just read the PDFs and then purchase a book.
Okay, that's really a valuable advice, ma'am, because many people, as you know, medical books are really costly and they immediately they go and buy the books and they think they could start immediately and they end up not knowing anything. So that would be really a great advice. And ma'am, next point we want to ask you is about this mental health issues that our medical field people face. And particularly, can we say that anesthesia people are at more risk for this stress?
I don't think so. I think mostly due to the pandemic, I think we are burned out, we are stressed out due to continuous ICU shifts, predominantly airway management in COVID-19. And also simultaneously dealing with cases. I think it was a bit hectic in recent times. I think it'll be fine to the coming people. Always be socially interactive, take time for yourself, take short breaks. I think it helps.
Okay, ma'am. So tell me, ma'am, what will be the future of your branch? If after completing the anesthesia residency, is it the end branch? Or do they really have a bright future getting into this society? Like they could go into fellowships or practicing on their own or getting into a corporate system. What would be the best thing and how will be the...
I think anesthesia is that one branch. It is good if you get into fellowships or super specialty, or it will be fine if you just continue with anesthesia also. There are coming to the options, you can straight away get into senior residency after your MD or DNB, or you can go into fellowships. There are different fellowships like ICU, that is critical care fellowship, or there's also DNB fellowship, DNB critical care.
Okay.
Neuro anesthesia, pediatric anesthesia, obstetric anesthesia, transplant anesthesia, pain and palliative care. Oh yeah, there are so many options.
There are really a lot of options, not just ending with anesthesia. You can go with other fellowships too. And it depends on a personal choice again. If they want to end there, they can end it and they can work. Or you can also take all the fellowships that that are listed by me.
Yeah, and there are also some foreign exams. European Diploma in Critical Care. European Diploma in Intensive Care. European Diploma in Anesthesia and Intensive Care. You can just give those exams to have an extra degree behind your name. Of course, it helps you to work in European countries also without much effort.
So if they have really a future aim of going into any other place or doing their residency or practice there, it would be really
easy. Yes.
So we have completed the second round too, which is the life of a PG aspirant, life of a PG student, how it will be when they enter into anesthesia branch. So I think you have gathered so much of information about the branch and also about the workload and also everything. And now we'll be moving on to the third segment. As I said, I'll be putting on some teasing questions to these anesthetists.
Interns, they don't even recognize us with our masks off. I don't think many of us know us. You know, in the family, yes. Especially after this COVID and all, they have known me very well and they usually call me. Initially, when they ask me what do I do, when I tell them an anesthetist, they used to ask me what do you do. I used to tell them I numb people before their surgery so that they don't have any pain and all. Okay, you're of no use to us. They used to talk like that. Later, when I told them that I also treat people in ICU, they need me in the time of their crisis, then slowly, even my parents do not know what I do in hospital, slowly they came to know. Cool heads. Uh, Immediately after the completion of your residency, I think in a corporate hospital, in a metro city, I think you learn anywhere between 1.2 to 1.5 lakhs. Without any night duties, I mean, just a 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. job. If you add a night duties, I think you can earn at least 20 to 30 k more. With a fellowship, even more, 40 to 50 k more than that. Freelancing, you can earn a bit more. It all depends on how much time you're going to invest into your job. OBGY, probably.
Why so?
I think they're scared of everything. They call for everything, all the emergencies. They get cases at any time possible. I think that's the reason. But no offense. Even my best friend is a gynecologist, and I also have a gynecologist at home. But I don't know. I just feel so. Yeah, that is one of the cons of anesthesia, I would say. Not very much. We don't get to talk to the patient a lot. Most of the time, we make them sleep. We just monitor their hemodynamics and all. And also, the patient trusts their surgeon more than their anesthetist. And the surgeon gets to patient gets to choose their surgeon and not the anesthetist. I feel that's just a con. There are many, like, if you're okay with it, I think you can go. It is not a very bad thing, I feel. Like, if you're really an introvert and you don't feel like talking too much, I think that's an advantage, according to me, than being a disadvantage from anesthesia point of view.
Thank you so much, ma'am. Thank you. Really, you have provided a lot of information about anesthesia and a lot of branches that they could opt after completing anesthesia and the importance of the branch and also many, many valuable points that they could take home and they could use that in their counseling. And thank you for being here, ma'am. And any points that you want to tell our subscribers?
Thank you so much, JTM, for having me here. It's really my pleasure guiding the future anesthetists. I would like to say a successful career does not happen. You will have to create it, and that applies to anesthesia too.
And that's all for today. Hope every one of your doubts have got clarified. If you really have any other doubts, then definitely you can ask them in the comments and ma'am would definitely answer all of them. And if you love this video, please do like, share and subscribe our channel, Dr. JTM. I'll be coming back with another great video on another career guidance video. Until then, bye. See you again.